Okay, well that's pretty muddy. So I'm going to take the camera off and I'll mount it, go back down, come back up through that again, a little bit neater than that. So bear with me, I'll be back. Rightio, that's as slippery as all hell. It's been pissing down rain, so let's go and have a look. It's very steep and very muddy and slippery. So I got through it, bit of a battle, but let's have a look at the tyre. The biggest problem there was probably lack of momentum, so got to give it a bit more. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to set the camera. There's a little rocky section up here. So, whoo, where's the pulse? 150. Righto, let's cool down a little bit. We'll do this hill. All right, let's analyze this. Very steep hill, very rocky here. So I had great traction through the rocks, absolutely no problems at all. Where my problem was I had to traverse backwards and forwards to get through some of these ditches in here. We've had probably 50 mil of rain in the last 48 hours out here, so it's very wet, which is why I wanted to do this today. There's no point just pounding up here in the dry. I wanted to challenge myself and the bike and see what it's like in the wet. So definitely it lacks traction, but you know, where's the compromise? Are you really going to ride something like this on your adventure bike on your 1200? So here's the thing, you might go out on a ride, you might do a 4000k ride, and you might come across one section like this. Is it worth wearing a tyre, using a tyre that's going to wear twice as fast, or just use a tyre that's going to get you out there, get you home, do really well on all the other surfaces? Man, look at that. So I haven't really ridden anything like this on the 1290, wet like this. All I would do if I did that again was I would probably just prep myself and come into it a little bit quicker. And honestly, 2 or 3 kilometers an hour faster would get me up over that stuff, no problem. So about a third of the way up, I'm not even. So I'm gonna go back to helmet cam, put it back on the camera on my helmet and film that. That is second gear as well. Oh. Yeah, the views. All right, I know there's a muddy section coming up, really black soil, so I'll leave the helmet cam on for that. Hopefully it, you'll see what happens. Hey, there we go. Right. One foot on the foot peg, lean forward. Let's go. Get up, get up, get up. Going sideways. There we go, back on top of it. Whoa, look at this. Legs going everywhere. Woo! Okay. Second gear. Too lumpy. Thank you. feeling this is the worst part now. I haven't been here for a few years. This will probably be the worst, so let's just get into it. Oh, the tree's not going to help. I'll get grip through that. I'm gonna take this rock section on over here. I can't see getting out of that. It's very sticky, so I'm gonna try that little bit up here. I get stuck, but let's have a bit of a crack. There we go. It is 149. That's what I do when I moto, 149 beats a minute. Crazy. Let's just roll through, get my heart rate down a bit. First gear. Oh, deep. Hill climb. The rocks aren't too bad. Or they are grey, not grey, they're really dark brown soil that's muddy. This stuff's alright. Full second gear. Get a bit more mumbo going. Rumble through all the rocks. Uh-oh, that's the first. Checky. Let's go, keep it going. Woo. Keep it going. Back to second. Gonna go back to first. Into the rockier line. Oh god, it's up there. Let's go. Into it. Uh-oh. What have we got? God. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed that. 148, so I'm working hard. Have a go at that. That is the scenic rim all around there, so all part of the Great Dividing Range. It's where I normally do my adventure bike riding, is out through this mountain range, all out through here. Pretty bloody amazing. So stoked to live here. We've got some amazing places to ride. And yeah, it's great. Out here by myself today. Loving it. Right, let's talk about these tyres so far. So on the rocks, they were fine. They were absolutely fine. I can punch second gear, punch through them, bang, bang, bang. The places where I'm struggling a little bit is sort of this stuff where it's just clay and it's wet. So, mate, if I was up here on a 450 with brand new motocross tyres, you'd still struggle. Not to that degree, but you would still struggle. So, you know, I've literally struggled in one spot and it was the first bit of stuff that I hit. So now that I've actually kind of got it in my head to just hit that stuff a little bit harder in second gear, a little bit more throttle and speed, not so much RPM, just a bit more speed, it punches through it okay. So I really don't think I'd ride my 1290 any places more extreme than this out here. I know a lot of guys have ridden this trail, but those from other areas that haven't, this is called Duck Creek Road. Pretty cool, about 10Ks, super steep. As you can see, super washed out. I hope the video comes out well to show you what it's all about. Anyway, today is all about a tire test, showing you how the tires work. Running these pants today as well. These are the Alpine Star Adventure pant. I'll put a link in below what they are. I am a bit hot. I just thought I'd give them a run, see what they're like. So they're comfortable. They're just a bit hot for today. Like I'm soaked, it's probably 35 degrees. So what I'm doing now is waiting for my heart rate. It's 120. I've got to wait for it to drop below 100. That's sort of my recovery zone. Resting pulse is about 50, but when you're exercising, got to drop back down to about 100, then I can do it again. So just relax, nice spot to relax. Got a bottle of water and a muesli bar. Yeah, it's Monday, pretty good. Let's get riding a bit more. That was fantastic. It's gonna be quite a big video. I thought I'd do like a 5 minute or a 10 minute tyre review, but why not throw this whole thing in so you get to enjoy that ride? It was awesome. Tell you something else really good. Now that I'm up here on top of the mountain range, I got a 33K twisting, winding road all the way back down to Conungra. Wasn't Binnaburra, it's O'Reilly's is up here. So that's a track to O'Reilly's. I said Binnaburra before. Get my mountains confused. So you can see we're right in the middle of the rainforest. Look at this. Bloody amazing. And again, people from Queensland, a lot of guys I know have ridden through here, but for others that haven't, hope you're enjoying it. So yeah, I'll hit the bitumen now. The road is a little bit wet in places, so this will be a good test as well. A little info, I'm running 30 PSI front and back for this ride. I normally run closer to 40, but I knew I was coming out here, so I dropped them down to 30. I think they've jumped up to about 32. No, they're on 31 and 28 in the rear. So yeah, now we'll hit the bitumen back down the hill into Conungra and then home. Actually, no, I'm going to go get some sushi.